Today we'll be reviewing how to set up and operate two Welch Allyn devices for screening the ear. The Welch Allyn AM282 audiometer is a single-channel, pure-tone, air conduction instrument designed to provide basic audiometric screening. The Welch Allyn TM286 autotemp is a versatile combination instrument that provides testing capability for tympanometry alone, tympanometry combined with screening acoustic reflex measurements, and screening audiometry. Testing with both devices is easy to learn once you understand each of the device buttons and what they do. Here's what is included with the TM286. Here's what is included with the AM282. Place the devices on a stable counter or table where it will be used in a quiet testing environment. The location should be near a properly grounded wall outlet. Here on the back of the device, you'll find the ports for attaching headphones, power supply. Here's a quick overview of the buttons on the AM282 audiometer. Here's a quick overview of the buttons on the TM286 autotemp. The directions for use included with your device includes a full reference section for the device buttons. Now we'll review how to conduct an audiometry test with the TM286 device. An audiometry test can be carried out with the AM282 device following the same general steps and using the same buttons and knobs. You'll turn on your device here. When power is turned on, the LCD will be illuminated and the orange light on the probe will be lit. The display on the LCD will show a scroll bar across the top to indicate the system is initializing. Allow the instrument 10 minutes to warm up. To switch from audiometry to tympanometry, simply press either the AUD or TIMP buttons. Perform the test in a quiet room and seat the patient in a position where they cannot see you pressing buttons. The most important thing to remember is that a good seal is required between the earphone cushion and the patient's head and ears. Eliminate all obstruction between the earphones and the ears, such as hair, eyeglasses, earrings or hearing aids, etc. Adjust the headband so that it rests solidly on the crown of the patient's head and exerts firm pressure on both ears. Center the headphones carefully over the ears. Make sure the diaphragm of the earphone is across from the ear canal opening. The earphone with the red connector goes on the right ear. Next, select the desired tone type, steady, pulsed, or frequency modulation. The frequency buttons help you increase and decrease the frequency you are presenting. The presentation button should be held for 1 to 1.5 seconds. The HL knob increases or decreases the signal intensity in 5 decibel increments. When the maximum or minimum available intensity is reached for any frequency, the display will flash. With the TM286, results display on screen and can be printed. With the AM282, make whatever notations your procedure requires on the provided audiogram forms. If you experience an issue with sound in either side of the headphones, it is possible to determine the source of the problem by switching the red and blue Y cords. Now we'll show you how to conduct a tympanometry test. Here is a selection of ear tips. 6 different size ear tips are provided with this instrument. You should inspect the ear canal opening to make sure there is no blockage or drainage, and this will also help you select the right size tip for your patient. A blinking green light means the instrument is ready to begin a tympanometry test. A steady green light means a test successfully started and is in progress. A yellow light indicates the probe is occluded. Remove the probe and inspect for cause of occlusion. If you see an orange light, a pressure leak has been detected. If a pressure leak occurs during the reflex testing and the pressure system is unable to correct for this leak, the reflex test sequence is aborted. When this occurs, the test results are assigned the letters NT, not tested. Once the tip is attached, it is ready to begin testing. Tympanometry is designed to start testing automatically. It is important that the patient remains still throughout the test. When a good seal is obtained, the blinking green lamp will change to a steady glow and remain steady while the test is in progress. When the test sequence is over, all lights on the probe will turn off. You can now remove the probe from the ear canal, and the results will display on the device screen before printing. When reviewing and interpreting results, refer to the tympanometry reference poster included with your device. The device will not show pass, refer, so the tester will need to understand the results. The test results are stored automatically in memory. The actual memory location number is determined by the number of tests that are stored. For example, if this is the first test to be stored in memory, it will be assigned the number M1. If it is the third test to be stored in memory, it will be numbered M3, etc., up to 12. The TM286 device will come with printer paper already installed. Press the paper advance button until a section of paper is long enough to pass through the printer cover. It's important to note that paper should be left in the printer at all times, even when it's not in use, which prevents the print head from sticking to the roller. Refer to the directions for use for more detail on replacing the paper roll. Welch Allyn recommends annual device calibration. Refer to your directions for use and other reference materials included with the AM282 audiometer and TM286 autotemp for detail on device setup and instruction.